Minister for Environment, Energy and Climate Change, Mr. Didier Dogle, Principal Secretaries, Chief Executive Officers, UNDP representatives, Director Generals, distinguished guests, teachers, students, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all for the launch of the Praslin Solar School Project. My name is Shani Stool. I am a student from Praslin Secondary School, and I will be your MC for this morning's ceremony. We have gathered here today to witness the launching of Phase 2, namely the Praslin Solar School Project. Let me present Jason Cass from Besatan Primary School to recite his poem entitled Solar Panel.
Mounted on the roof, seated on the ground, anchored on the water, with a flat plate structure, was mono than poly, but also as thin film cells, even sometimes transparent it gets. A great man's invention, the solar panel. Operating silently, without any moving parts or environmental emissions, you make your own energy from the anger of sunshine bombarding the earth each day. Go green with solar photovoltaic panels, which gives us a happy channel with its highly promising future, both on economic viability and environmental sustainability. Solar panels are innovative. Solar energy is incredible. Solar power has earned its place. In all our hearts with growing craze, be part of the cool gang.
I now have the pleasure of inviting Mr. Didier Dogle, Minister for Environment, Energy and Climate Change, to deliver his speech.
Government has taken the necessary steps to make sure that all schools benefit from solar energy. We started last year with the school on La Digue, and I know that we almost completed the work that needs to be done there. And this year, we've made sure that three schools on La Digue, on Praslin, that is the secondary school at Grantas and both the primary schools at Besatan and at Grantas have all benefited from renewable energy. Renewable energy is not anymore a luxury. It's not something which is special anymore. It is basically a need. And we'll keep on investing until all the schools in Seychelles, all the public schools in Seychelles, have solar PV on their roofs, and the kids can benefit from that infrastructure that has been added to their school. But it will also help bring down the amount of money that school has to pay to PUC every month for them to be able to meet their energy needs, thereby releasing money for those head teachers to use it for other purposes, to buy books, maybe to take the kids to other places, excursions where they can learn other things rather than putting the money into paying bills of PUC. I also would like to thank the contractors that I believe has done an excellent job to make sure that the PV solar system has been installed and that it will be operational very soon for all the kids and the school to benefit with. So I thank all of you for coming and listening and being part of this launching. Thank you very much.
I would now like to call upon a group of students from Praslin Secondary School to present their drama entitled Aider pour réduire consommation l'énergie.
La cuisine comme Maxwell qui va bien. Et Maxwell, il parle ici qui casse des gros clés aux électroniques. Moi aussi, moi casse des gros clés aux électroniques. Il parle un an, mon maman, un mois. Ça fait tout la bande dans les dos, qui nous fait pas du bateau. Pas la fin.
Eh, mon bala, fais-moi pas une fois, c'est à ce café, hein, c'est. Mourage. Ok, quand tout ça, les temps, on peut utiliser ça, c'est quelque chose. Ah, mais dis tout ça, les autres, tu fais compétition avec moi ou?
Mais, excusez-moi, je vais faire la chance avec vous. Ah, comment ça, taille ça, les autres là-bas?
Let us invite Miss Elke Talma, the project manager for the government of the Seychelles, UNDP-GEF photovoltaic project, to do a short presentation.
So just to explain to you roughly what PV is, as the gentleman pointed out, we have tiles on the roof. They're not really tiles, they're solar panels. And I apologize for the quality of the screen, but the panels, normally you stick them on the roof because it's out of the way and won't get damaged. And basically what they do is they receive the rays from the sun and they produce DC power. This energy then goes through an inverter and is converted to AC power, which is what we use to power our fridges, lights, and everything. But because of the net metering in Seychelles, what happens is, from the AC, from the inverter, this is the energy goes through a PV meter and straight into the PUC grid. So at the end of the month, when PUC comes to read your meter, they take two readings. A reading of your PUC consumption and a reading of your PV production. And they do a quick calculation, and your electricity bill is basically reduced because your production is deducted from your consumption. How does the school benefit? Well, for one thing, you save money. Okay, so depending on the size of your installation, obviously, you might not save as much as you wish, and if it keeps raining like that, you're not gonna save much anyway. But another thing that you can do is use the data in your curriculum. So with the PV system, we have an SMA inverter, and most of the schools have connected with a web box, so you can actually access the data online. And so you can actually do in your geography classes, maths classes, physics classes, we've just seen drama, we've had a poem. So there's a whole range of subjects that you can use photovoltaic or renewable energy in. And so in the first graph is basically looking at the daily production. So this is a near perfect graph where it starts production at 6 o'clock in the morning, peaks at lunchtime, and then drops down. Because at night, PV doesn't work. Okay? So this would be a perfect day. Today is not a perfect day for PV production, but you can use these and compare how PV changes throughout the day. You can also compare throughout a month how it varies between different days. So as you can see, there's some days with lots of production, and then you have other days where not so great, because it was probably very rainy or overcast. And finally, you can actually compare between years. How does PV change over time? Because as I mentioned before, your PV panels are going to last a good 25 years, so you've got at least 25 years worth of analysis that you can do and get the students involved. Okay, and just to wrap up, the whole reason we're doing this is basically to give nature a fighting chance. We want to reduce our carbon emissions, and the way to do that, as far as I'm concerned, is to go solar.
Let me call on the group of students from Grantas Praslin Primary School who has prepared a special song for this momentous occasion entitled L'Energie.
Nous vannes le ciel et la et aussi de son son bon oiseau. L'humanité peut vivre dans l'harmonie avec la nature.
L'élément et moi spolition.
Ms. Elaine Enesta, Project Manager for GOS-UNDP-GEF-RE Project, to do a short presentation.
The Resource Efficiency Project, we use RE for short, or in Creole, Pour les Efficacités des Ressources. The main title is the promotion and upscaling of climate resilient resource efficient technologies in a tropical island context. So it's a 4-year project with a funding from the GOS-UNDP-GEF of $1.7 million, aiming to create the appropriate environment to transform and strengthen the market of resource-efficient appliance and technologies. We have 4 components. One of the first components is about improving the policy and institutional capacity in legal regulations and financial framework for resource-efficient technologies. Second component is about awareness raising and educational campaign on resource efficient appliances. And third component is about training schemes to support development for market of energy efficient appliances and water saving devices. Fourth component is about financing mechanism to support adoption of resource efficient technologies in the Seychelles. So what do? We become more efficient. It's simple. We start by switching off the lights when you leave a room. You unplug all your appliances as they keep using electricity, even when on standby. You take a shower. You don't fill up your bathtub with all the water. You do rainwater harvesting. It's been raining a lot right now. I'm sure we all are cultivating the rainwater to wash our cars and our gardens. Well, you don't need to water your gardens right now. But it's water that you can save for later use when it's a little bit more dry. Well, just be careful with all the dengue and the mosquitoes. But otherwise, it's resource available which we can make use of. It's hot in Seychelles. Everybody's going for aircon now. So it's okay. I mean, we need to take our own comfort, and we can put it at 26 degrees Celsius because then it uses less energy to circulate the air. And also, when you're using aircon, close off your doors. Just make sure all your windows are closed also, okay? Next, another tip is, rather than going with your PC, you can get a laptop, and also we can switch bulbs. Use energy savers or LEDs. I mean, in future, there might be other names that comes along. So let's just say energy saving bulbs, okay? And then how do we identify energy saving? So we check energy ones that A stars and above are the better ones. They are a bit pricier, but that's why we have this scheme available to help people move forward in getting energy efficient technologies. Additionally, I've given everybody energy saving tips. Thank you very much.
Comment les élèves qui ont engagé de bonnes activités et projets organisés en bas programme Eco School Seychelles et qui aussi membre TIPS en mi-valet-mé, mon compte les moi bon partenaire pour investir dans le développement nous bonne l'école. Ça pose pour mettre beaucoup de bénéfices pour nous bonne l'école l'eau pour aller, tel que réduction de bonne bille électricité tous les mois et l'implémentation de bonnes pratiques qui encouragent l'utilisation efficace nous bonnes ressources telles que l'énergie et de l'eau. L'énergie solaire est pour nous, et il tape à plusieurs reprises dans nos jolis environnements l'école. Sa projet va aider pour nous résoudre et servir plus sa source l'énergie qui bordait bénit nous avec pour produire l'électricité qui va servir de communauté logique. Merci pour m'aider. Nous, il faut espérer nous avoir bonne activité éducationnelle qui est organisée pour tout bon l'école le pralé. Nous avons appris plus le bon pratique, le bon différentes sources d'énergie qui propre pour n'en rien qui pas en main fini. En même temps, nous avons aussi apprendre bonne pratique et technologie qui aide pour réduire gaspillage nos bonnes ressources et qui aussi pour mode bonne façon adaptation et mitigation changement climatique. Encore une fois, un gros merci.